Sirius, also known as the Dog Star, is one of the most brilliant stars in the night sky. It is also one of the closest to our own solar system, being only 8.6 light years away. It is located in the constellation known as Canis Major, which represents the Great Dog and is one of Orion's hunting dogs. This bright star is actually a binary system. It has a companion white dwarf star, and they orbit each other every 50 years. It has been used for navigation, agricultural timing, and has a deep cultural significance in many cultures. So in this video, we're going to explore this nearby system and strategies you can use to help you find it. Welcome to Learn the Sky. My name is Janine, and I'll be your guide as we explore the night sky one constellation at a time. First, we're going to look at the general characteristics of this binary star system. So Sirius A is the larger and brighter of the two stars in this system, while Sirius B is classified as a white dwarf star. Sirius A is a white main sequence star, so both of these stars are in different phases of their evolution. They revolve around each other every 50 years, and they're fairly close together at 20 astronomical units apart. Again, it is located 8.6 light years away. That's why it's so bright in our night sky. If you look at this photo right here, this is Sirius A, and then this little dot right here is Sirius B. This photo was taken by the Hubble Space Telescope. And the name Sirius comes from the Greek word Sirios, which means scorching or glowing. And if we want to take a look at the size comparison, this is what Sirius A would look like. And here is Sirius B, so it's much smaller, but they are both white stars. This one is cooler, while this one is much, much hotter, and we'll explore why that is in a little bit. So let's dive in and look at Sirius A. This is a white main sequence star, and it's about 2 times the mass of our own sun, and almost 2 times the radius. It clocks in at about 1.7 times the radius of the sun, and it's 25 times more luminous than our own sun, and it is hotter. It's just about 10,000 Kelvin. It's classified as a class A star, which means it is white in color. And one cool fact I found about Sirius A and B, because they're both a star system, is that the Voyager 2 spacecraft will pass really closely to this star system within 4 light years of it. And this won't happen for about 300,000 years, but I just thought that was something cool about this star. And then let's look at Sirius B. This is a white dwarf star, which means it's evolved past the main sequence phase of its life, as well as the red giant phase. So it's no longer fusing any hydrogen or helium. It's just really, really hot leftover core of a star. It is about the same size, or I'm sorry, mass. It's about the same mass of the sun, but it is much smaller. Look how much tinier it is here, 0.0084 radii of the sun. So it's really tiny. And then it's also very dim. So this is not a star you can see with the naked eye. You're only really able to see Sirius A. This star is also nicknamed the pup star because it's the smaller of the two. When we look at the size of the Sirius system with our own solar system, we can see that Sirius A is much larger than our own sun. But when you compare Sirius B with Earth, the Earth is just a bit bigger than Sirius B. And I learned that Sirius B is pretty large for a white dwarf star when you compare them to the rest of the ones that we have been studying. And then if we were to look at the Hertzsprung-Russell diagram, and I have a whole video on the HR diagram. It's how we classify stars by brightness, temperature, color. Okay, so we would have the classification here, stellar classification, which equates to color as well as temperature. And then here you have the brightness on the side. So let's get acquainted with where we are. Here is where the sun is. We are classified as a G star. And Sirius A is located right here. And this star right here, that's Vega. So Vega and Sirius are very close in size, but their shape is different. Vega has a little bit more flattened at the poles because it's rapidly rotating. And then Sirius B is down here. So that means it's dimmer than the sun, but it's much hotter as well. If you look at this here, this is where the sun is. Sirius is brighter and it is hotter than our own sun. And when we look at the 25 brightest stars in the night sky, Sirius is the brightest star that we can see in the night sky. The only other things that are brighter than Sirius would be the moon, our sun, as well as some of the planets like Mars and Jupiter and Venus. So as you can see, if we zoom in, Sirius is here and it's also very close to us. So when we look at the sun's closest neighbors, here's the sun, and if we go out a few light years, this is where Sirius A and B would be, just 8.6 light years away. So it's kind of like the fifth closest star system to us. And remember, you're not able to see Sirius B with the naked eye, but when you look at it, like this beautiful photo right here, when you are looking at Sirius, which is very easy to find, know that you're seeing this binary star system. Now let's explore how to find Sirius in the night sky. It is one of the easiest stars to find, not just because it's the brightest star in the night sky, but it also sits right next to Orion in the sky, and you can use Orion to help guide you to many other constellations in this area of the night sky. So remember that Sirius is a part of the constellation known as Canis Major, which is Orion's hunting dog. Remember, the key to finding Sirius in the night sky is using Orion. You want to find Orion and use the belt stars to point you towards Sirius. Orion is so important in finding many constellations in this part of the sky. Another way to find Sirius is to use an asterism known as the winter triangle. As you look at this photo, you should be able to hopefully see the three brightest stars, and they connect to make a triangle just like this. And the brightest star in that triangle is Sirius. The other stars we have are Betelgeuse, which is a part of Orion, and Procyon, which is a part of Canis Minor, which is Orion's small hunting dog. I've got another photo here for you of the winter triangle. Hopefully you're able to see the three brightest stars, make that connection, and then the brightest one is Sirius. If we point out the other constellations, here we have Orion, we have Canis Major and Canis Minor. Thank you so much for watching this video about Sirius. Now, when you go outside and find the brightest star in the night sky, you're actually looking at a binary two-star system. And I know I didn't even touch on all the different type of mythologies and stories that are connected to this very culturally significant star, but there is a lot to unpack there, so I want to take the time and do it justice. So I hope you can go outside, find Sirius, and if you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching, and as always, keep looking up.